The watchmaker Yema is a historically significant watch brand from France that started in 1948, so this is not a micro brand. It is in fact a legit watchmaker with tradition and pedigree. Like many other brands that suffered after the quartz crisis, Yema was eventually acquired by Seiko in 1988 and then made its way back to France in 2004, before being finally acquired by the Morteau-based Montre Ambre watch brand. So they have quite a history and tradition. This beautiful tiny diver is in fact a heavy gun called Yema Navigraph Heritage. It's a reissue of the 1970s original diver, the Navigraph. Having only 39mm case diameter, this retro diver does double duty as a waterproof everyday beater and as a funky dress watch and even more. How much more? Well, a dress diver full in house. That much more. Which is all that watch collectors are searching for. If you like what you are seeing, please consider subscribing to my channel. It will help me bringing more quality content. Thank you very much. Is beautiful, is tiny, is full in house, is dressy. This vintage retro-looking diver is a real deal, a powerhouse. The button like hour and minutes hands, the exclamation point indices and the extremely long yellow second hand sweeping over the dark inky black dial, the Navigraph challenge perfection, and since we are at this chapter, I need to be honest and point out that the loom is rather disappointing for a full in-house exclusive limited edition watch. Don't get me wrong, the lume is awesome, even the gorgeous sapphire bezel is lit, but unfortunately is not long lasting and maybe this is the only bad thing that I can found to the watch. Handling the watch, the first thing that hits you, you realize besides being very well made, in fact it's so tiny. Case diameter, lug distance and bracelet overall, all about it is undersized. Relatively speaking, it's almost lady size that you almost not taking it seriously as a man. But once at your wrist, this is the place where the watch shine. The case is well machined with fantastic brushed surfaces. I'm not a big fan of highly polished watches. That's why the brushed metal finishing holds up very well against the occasional scuff and scratch. And this watch does exactly that. I said well machined. And yes, the case, the bracelet, the watch as a whole, you feel that the human hand had little to do in regard with the fit and finish. In terms of quality and machining, the watch ticks all the boxes. The Navigraph is in the range of just under $1,000. For a non-Swiss diver, some say it's a lot, but as I just said earlier, Yema is an established brand through and through. You get a full in-house certified diver. For underwater adventures, the anti-reflective sapphire crystal and orange indices over the deep black dial are the perfect combination, but who in the right mind will take this dressy diver into the water? The watch tick all the boxes, sapphire crystal, diver's extension, solid handling, ISO diving certification, in-house build, unidirectional sapphire bezel, black dial and orange indices. This is a true diver 100%. An in-house mechanical movement is a badge of honor amongst watch collectors. Designed and developed at their Morteau workshops, the caliber MBP1000 beats at 28,800 AH, and they did say it's accurate to plus minus 12 seconds per day. but for this watch here, it's more like plus 6 seconds per day, which is inside chronometer specifications. Adorned with Yema Flowery family crest, the case back cover lets you know which of the 500 Heritage limited edition pieces has joined your collection. If you want a watch that can start a conversation, then the Yema Navigraph is a winner. If you want a hardy, subtle, stylish and legible timepiece from a non-Swiss independent watchmaker all in-house for less than $1,000, then this Yema Navigraph is definitely worth considering.